The Arizona State Museum is the oldest and largest museum of anthropology in the southwestern United States. As an anthropology museum, it's really focused on preserving knowledge, creating knowledge, and sharing knowledge about the peoples and cultures of our region here in the southwestern United States and northern Mexico. So ASM is really, really pleased and proud to have now three American Treasure designations. The first being our collection of whole southwestern ceramic vessels, our collection of American Indian basketry and fiber arts, and most recently we received a designation related to our collection of photographs, which includes more than 525,000 photographs, prints, transparencies, and movie films. And we are actually the only institution in the country to have three collections so honored.
Photographs play a big role in that they tell us something about how something was excavated, what conditions it was excavated under. They also document how they were put on display before, and they allow us to see what has happened over time.
We have baskets similar to that in our collection. I don't think any collection in the United States has the depth and breadth about the peoples of the Southwest and the impact of change and time. People can see objects in context. They can see how we have the mammoth bone bed from the Naco excavations, and there's spear points embedded in the bones. And people can see how the archaeologists uncovered that bone bed, and then how they were able to recover it as a whole unit and the process that they followed to safely remove it from the wash where it was found.
What's exciting here is this is exactly how the archaeologists found it in 1951, and in 52 excavated it with these large stone points, hunting points, in place in the bone.
When archaeologists excavate a site, they're actually destroying it. They're removing the associations between objects and destroying the context. And if that process is not done properly and recorded properly, and if the records are not curated properly in the future, it's as if that site never existed and we lose all of that information. ASM's collections are really, really, really well documented, and that is part of the tremendous value of them. We can go back and reconstruct minute details of what happened in the past as a result. Like these.
I think it's great that the photographic collections can be dealt with now, because this project will benefit from everything that was learned by the pottery project and the basketry project. And it's totally true that if we understand the past, we may do a better job at predicting the future and dealing with the future.
Our mission is to protect these objects, photographs, pottery, basketry, tools, jewelry, everything, so that future generations can learn. This is a resource that's available to everybody. Just because we're on a campus, a lot of people think they can't come here, and it's sad because we're here for the entire world, really, and we're here to serve. We're state servants. I feel grateful. I feel grateful that I can do this and be there for people and share this with people. It's an immensely gratifying bit of work.